I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claiming you my dog and then you hold on me? Nowadays they ain't showing real loyalty. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Taking victory laps, I'm in the hood with them ones. Catch me out in Decatur with some meat and potatoes. Waffle House in Atlanta. I hit the blue flame.
Later tonight in November, snowfall is forecasted to hit the Twin Cities. But right now, calm outside. And, of course, a calm day inside U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. It can certainly get loud inside this building. And just a few moments ago when the Vikings were introduced, it was downright shaking in here. They're set for football as the Vikings get ready to do battle with the Green Bay Packers. This taken in at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. Takes this one up past the 20 after he's able to make a man miss. 5 yards on the game's first play, second down. This defense for the Packers, they were terrific a week ago in the win over Seattle.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get two or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back 4 times in the win.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Throwing, Cousins. That one complete to D.D. Westbrook. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. So, Charles, defensively here, you're going up against a veteran quarterback. He's got a lot of know-how, a ton of savvy, but guy who's not the most mobile of quarterbacks. What's the plan of attack?
You spend all week pumping up your defensive front. Your defensive tackles, your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys who go after the quarterback the most, because you know that he's not going to run and beat you consistently throughout the game. You can rush more aggressively off the edge and even up the middle, because even if he evades you, he's not going to go very far. You have a lot more confidence going after him in the pocket.
Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Cousins now. Swinging this out wide here for Cook. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
So into Packer territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 43.
We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three. Get.
Cousins gives way to Cook. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by Devondre Campbell.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10.
You got three. Three down, three down. Check nine, check nine.
Yellow, yellow, yellow.
Cousins to throw it. Open man here is Conklin. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
That's a gain of 8. Brings up 3rd and 2.
Off the play fake, Cousins. Eluding the pressure right. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game as it brings up fourth down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Throwing his Cousins. Flushed out right. Open here, Adam Thielen. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
And that's a big pickup on the first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. First down, here's the run with Cook. Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8. Second and 2, first down marker at the 8.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2.
Play action now. Cousins rolling to his right. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Tyler Conklin, his third touchdown now. And the Vikings take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Out of his end zone comes Andy Isabella. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. On play action, it's Rodgers. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Almost feels like anything you can do, we're going to try and match or do better. We've already seen one touchdown pass from the opposition. They tried to equal it on that throw.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. On play action, now Rodgers. Pressure coming from the Vikings, and they get there and bring it down. Credit the sack to the Oregon Duck, DeForest Buckner. On fourth down, on is Corey Bohorquez to punt. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. An update from Buffalo. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good. And looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
Working with a second and four. From the pistol, they run it with Cook. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Third and short yardage, Cousins. And that's going to be caught. It's Rico Gafford. And he will have a Vikings first down by a couple of yards as they're able to get four there on third and two.
As you know, so many things in the passing game are based on yardage. Sometimes it's just based on timing. And that's what we saw right there on that play. Third and three, just get the ball right to the receiver.
It's the hitch route. And tell us, what is the hitch route?
Yeah, just take really one step, like you're driving off the line of scrimmage, get the defensive back on his heels, get the ball out to the receiver, and he does the rest.
Here's second and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Now Cousins. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
They'll run on first down. It's Cook, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Cook. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 28.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first down, Cook. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
And that's why Dalvin Cook is the Minnesota Vikings feature back. He put the ball in his hands, good things happen. Second in the NFL last year in rushing with 1,557 yards. And that's now back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons with 30 combined total touchdowns. What a player is Dalvin Cook.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, Cousins. Herndon's got it complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
44,
On second down, Cook. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Cousins. And this is incomplete. Something of a rare incompletion. And remember, Charles, last week under 50% throwing the football. That's what he was. But he has turned that around in this game.
Last week was commonly known as a fluke. For him to be under 50%, not normal, not the usual. But to be up over 80%, that's extra time in practice. And that's throwing with extra confidence as well.
They'll run for it with Cook. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield.
A 5 yard loss sets up third down and goal.
Third and goal for Cousins. Escaping the pressure right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one score lead, two score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, and he opted for the touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. They'll roll him out right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Packers. Even later into his career now, there aren't too many guys that can launch it downfield with accuracy better than Aaron Rodgers.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
Nwangu now from his end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they may just be content to take this three-point lead and head into the locker room. A first down throw for Cousins. Going up top. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years. The arm strength is still there, and he showed it off on that one.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
And that throw, amazingly, well over 70 yards in the air, according to Next Gen Stats. Wow. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And here's Lewis. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see what they want to do. Just 20 seconds remaining here before the half. He'll buy some time right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Flush to his right. And he'll just get rid of it. Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
Time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. They'll run for it. Chubb, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action. Ready for the third quarter. Isabella now from his end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I...
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off at the 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the big boy, dare I say, he showed some athleticism there.
Oh, without a doubt. And you know what else we saw on that play? Why they do more and more ball drills in practice. They want everyone proficient with catching the football and being comfortable, because you never know when a big play like this will happen for a big man.
Now, post-game locker room, does he get an extra drumstick?
He was going to get that anyway. He may get the whole spread now.
Yeah, put some gravy on there. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Isabella now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount. Here's his opportunity.
It comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. He just got a
touchdown, Packers! Nick Chubb, about as dynamic a runner as the NFL has to offer. He put his talents on full display there. That was some kind of run. extra point try good by Gadeau. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. Gadeau now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Nwangu now from his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Cousins eluding the pressure right. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point. That's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
So first and 10 now from the 30. From the gun, here's Cousins. Buying time to his left. And his throw is going to be incomplete. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
But you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers to get together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Let's it fly for Thielen. And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
So one first down on that drive, and that's it. Forced to take the deep shot on third down and couldn't hit it. Now they have to punt this one away.
Here's Jordan Berry now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. This will be fielded at the 17. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They come in off a touchdown drive the last time they had the ball to cut down that lead. Now the defense has done their part, got them the football back.
Momentum started to shift a little bit when they scored the touchdown. It increased when the defense got them the ball back. Momentum definitely in their favor. Now they got to keep things cranking, keep it on high so they can keep cutting into that lead.
Glad to have you with us from Minneapolis. Third quarter here, second and 10. Throwing now is Rodgers. That ball complete to Isabella. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does. And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and 9, Rodgers flushed out right. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. A big connection on that one. 36 yards. On first down, they'll run with Chubb. Open space inside the 10. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. 118 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On the sneak, Rodgers. And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Packers are back within a score. Gano the extra point. And the lead is down to a field goal. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Nwangu now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
Vikings now to start their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. First down, here's Cousins. Escaping the pressure right. Lets it fly for Thielen. Oh, wide open, complete. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he reaches the 38. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. And he wisely will throw that one away. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
I
Good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game. Second and 10. Here's Cousins. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And the Packers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or they want to take the big strike and go after it right now.
They run it again with Chubb. Finding room at the 30. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They give the Chubb out of the gun. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. And even 150 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play, because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. Going out wide, finds Chubb. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. In this case, he picks up the first down.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Sliding out of the pocket. That is caught. It's the tight end, Tonyan. And it's a Packers touchdown. Robert Tonyan, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Packers have taken the lead. They're quite the comeback here. They have erased that deficit, pushed themselves out in front now here in this fourth quarter.
This game's kind of felt like a horse race, hasn't it, partner? Because, yeah, the other guys run out to their big lead, but then slowly and surely, they've been creeping up and closing that gap. Now they've stuck ahead in front here late in the game. The finish line's not far away. They need their defense to finish this thing off.
Nwangu now from his end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Now the bad news for them, they've seen that cushion they once had totally evaporate, and they're working from behind. The good news, they now have the opportunity to regain the lead right back. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Vikings! Kirk Cousins with three touchdown passes now in the afternoon. And the Vikings are going to retake the lead. Might be seeing that one on the highlight shows tonight. The home run ball here in the fourth quarter to take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through all the way through. Go ahead and throw one more up there. Why not?
Been a great game, and we are not done yet. Point after, right down the middle, and that gives them a three-point lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Isabella now from his end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
Lakers take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Fights him off, and he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 161 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues. A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. And again, it's Chubb. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. A give running right is Chubb, and they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Dumps this to his running back, Chubb. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Flush to his right. Less than two to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. A give. This is Chubb. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Viking territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on 3rd down. That's Isabella open on the right side. And he is going to have a Packers 1st down by a couple of yards as they're able to get 4 there on 3rd and 2. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on third down. Even better decision.
From the gun, it's a give to Chubb. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Second and 11 now. Now Rodgers. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. He's going to drop this one down for Chubb. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's fourth down.
They got the completion. Now they probably had two plays called in the huddle, so they've got to get to the line of scrimmage, get set, and run their fourth down play.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This could potentially send us to overtime. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So they hadn't called on him at all until this point, but he comes through here and buries one from long range.
Yeah, that's awfully impressive because usually kickers like to get that first one out of their system in the first quarter, sort of get them into the flow of the game, but to come in this late and knock it down from long distance, give him a lot of credit.
Cousins to throw. He's going to air one out. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. So four quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dime. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Isabella now from his end zone. Ready to get their next drive underway. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now. The ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. One play has them to the 37 here for first and 10. A run for Nick Chubb. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Wow, and even 200 yards rushing for him now as he is just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Chubb running right. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. They've had some success here in overtime with this opening drive running the football right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think there's more water there available to them.
They go with Chubb on second down. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three. Another timeout called by the Vikings now. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. So a big play in this opening drive of overtime. Now looking at a third and three. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Overtime with less than 2 minutes to play, and we are still all tied. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Handoff comes to Chubb. And room there to work it inside the 25. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And I know you, with every carry, especially in overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settling, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here. I know the defensive guys poking, clawing, breaking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. He finds his way into the secondary again on this drive. They might want to try getting him down a little closer to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, what do they call that? Third level run, first level being the D-line, and linebacker second level in the secondary, the third. When you block it up well and you make the secondary do all the tackling, that will wear on a defense.
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. And he brings it back to the house. It's a touchdown. And in a crazy inning, a defensive score wins it. Well, I know at points in this one you wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. You're a defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people who really enjoyed this game? They're the ones that like going to batting practice at the Major League Baseball parks, right? Seeing the 14-11 game, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So for Green Bay, they move back over 500 now at 6-5. And they'll return home next week to take on the LA Rams. Meanwhile, for Minnesota, it's a bit of a setback as they drop to 6-4 now. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to Santa Clara to take on the 49ers.